last films you did with Mr. Ray, Shakha Proshakha, you played a role of a mentally retarded sort of a thing. Now, was that easier to do than to play a normal person? I mean,
No, it wasn't. Because, you know, I'll tell you what happened during this. When he decided to make this film, he told me that, look, I'm going to make a film of that script which I wrote for your magazine 25 years back. I'm going to update it and rewrite it, and I'm going to make a film out of it. And there is this role of a brother of the three brothers, which has very few spoken words for him, maybe 20 or 25 lines. But I want someone very dependable, so I want you to play that role. I was overjoyed to get that role, and then when our work progressed, he said that, look here, Soumitra, these very words, I have given you enough independence during your whole career to think and play your role as you like. But in this particular film, I'm afraid we will have to work together. Because in a person who is mentally deranged, or who hasn't got a mental equilibrium, the behavior pattern can be of infinite variety. So we'll have to select only those which are significant for this script and this particular story. So there, I believe your and mine observations should coincide and tally with each other. So then he started, for example, later on, he said some other day that it is seen, observed generally, that in a person of such mental illness, they have developed a kind of a physical mannerism. Most of them have. I said, yes, I have observed that too. And he said then that I wish that you play with your hand. I said, what kind of play you wanted? He said, this character thumps on the table or on his head or on the sofa seat where he is. He constantly does like that. And that appealed to me very much. Later on in that particular scene when he sort of, during the eating scene, when he's becomes very disturbed and keeps on thumping on the table, I added another physical thing, that kind of ticking the neck and neck muscles, and because that came from my observation, but the basic thing was his. That's how two of us kind of collaborated.
You know, you have this great love for theatre, and you keep going back to theatre from cinema all the time, even to this day. What is it about theatre that is so gratifying, that makes you want to go back to?
Well, the first thing is, it's my first love. That's I can't forget the theatre. Couldn't even, when I was so busy with the films that I couldn't go to the theatre, I used to long to be on stage. And then, in order not to forget technique, I used to take a part in sort of shows that we staged for the Actors Guild, Avinetri Sangho. And in 1978, when I thought that I can't remain outside the theatre anymore, I took a plunge, and at that time I was so busy. Even now I am busy with the film, but that was making a break, because no one wanted me to go to the theatre at that time, particularly the industry people. They thought that it's I will not be able to give them proper time. Just a moment. And is it rolling?
Yeah.
another desire must be to be on the stage is that there I write the script, I make adaptation myself, and then I direct the play, and that's the most complete job that I can imagine of. That gives me a lot of satisfaction and at least a lot of enthusiasm. And well, you may say that, why don't you direct a film? The question comes obviously, you know, the film, directing a film means about a whole time activity for 6 to 8 months at least. And my commitments with the Bengali film industry does not allow me that time to, I mean, to keep away from other acting assignments or even the practical reality of not earning any other money from other films for about most of the year is rather difficult. And then also the another difficulty is there, that the kind of film I would like to make is very difficult to find backers here in Calcutta. Even think of a great artist like Satyajit Ray. He did not find a private backer for the last few films of his. Three of them, to at least I can remember, all of them are either NFDC or the government or something like that. So that discourages me a lot. And but for the theatre, the sheer fact of myself being in the cast also, I can use my star value and create my kind of theatre at my will. And that's what I am doing. I mean, in the professional theatre world, for the last 15 years, I'm a big exception. I mean, I'm doing, these kind of plays are being done in the group theatre level. But I don't believe in group theatre. I believe that a theatre should try and attract the majority of audience. And in fact, remains that the majority of our audience goes to the public theatre to see, watch plays. So it is that place where I have to do good plays.
Is that why you also do jatras?
No. To be honest, these jatra or the semi-jatras that I'm doing, it's entirely for money. Plain and simple, because they pay you very handsomely. And say, doing 10 or 15 or 20 such appearances during the winter, well, gives me enough to carry on through the year.